live at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington, Texas, where Nebraska is looking to mess with Texas in a championship matchup that has its history of upsets in the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship on ABC. For the Longhorns, folks, the stakes are sky high. No margin for error tonight. While the Husker Nation attempts to throw the college football world into a frenzy with an upset.
This will be back deep for the Horns. The stadium that has set a new standard for stadiums in this country, and we are underway. And it'll come out on the 20-yard line. And so, Herbie, here comes... Shuttle pass on the inside to Newton. Newton breaks free. A first down at the 36-yard line. Keeping it deflected. Could be intercepted. It is picked off at the 40-yard line. The deflection sent it up in the air. And Nebraska with the first turnover of the game as Eric Hag comes down with it. H the fullback. And Burkhead stays in on third and short. He'll follow the fullback. Has to battle back, and the Horn defense, very stout in the middle, would not let him. Stays in. Behind Ndamukong. Cut back. It's going to be very close. It's going to depend on the spot. I don't think he got it if that spot that I'm looking at is where they're going to put the football. With a second
here in this first possession.
Third and seven for Zach Lee. Going to throw it. Got one-on-one down the near side. End zone. And waved off. They say that the receiver ran long for this season. But he hit a 57-yarder in Lincoln against Colorado. This for 45 yards on the money. Is it long enough? And he has put him ahead. Alex Henry, who will punt. And the running back next to McCoy on this third and five. Both incomplete. This time it's three and out for the block. For the Horns, made a fine defensive play there. Second down and nine, and Lee now going to come deep down the far side. Intercepted by Gideon. Blake Gideon hauls it in, so it's a pick apiece. Five defensive backs. McCoy waits. Near side. Intercepted. Picked off. That is the second interception. Amu Kamara. And now you talked about the Horns. Well, the Cornhuskers with these two, they now have 18 interceptions in a yard. The middle of that Texas defensive line has been stout here early. They're going to throw on it. Third down in trouble. Has to throw it away. And here is fourth down and a decision to be made by bringing the heat. And here it is. A 52-yard attempt. Remember I told you he's hit a 57-yarder. He whacks it. Looks like he's got it. Brilliant. Two field goals
for pass protection of Texas's offensive line.
Third and 17 for McCoy. He'll come underneath, juggled, and dropped. Incomplete. Williams couldn't hold on that time. So here is that third and two, a manageable third down for the Huskers. And Zach, straight back, has time, fires complete, got the first down. And that is Paul, Niles Paul, the receiver, and that's textbook.
That is. This is
the slot receiver on this third and seven for the top of your screen. Comes back near side, high, incomplete, and this time Nebraska will
expect that aspect of your game.
This time Colt will keep it himself. Big gap on the left to the 30-yard line and a first down for the long
two man on third and short.
Comfortable in the slot. McCoy looks away. Comes back to the flat and they lose yardage on that play. Newton is hit by Philip Dillard, the junior from Danville. Lori Heller back in as the I back. Play fake and Zach is going to throw it. Going to go for it right after the block punt. Paul battle end zone. Intercepted. Picked off by Williams. Aaron Williams, his third interception of the season. He picks it off and it'll come out on the 20-yard. On third down, McCoy forced out of the pocket, comes in underneath. And that, of course, is to his buddy. This time, McCoy able to stay in the pocket, hits Buckner, and Buckner picked up on ABC. Third down and two. McCoy rolling to the right. And great coverage with Sue coming up at the end of that play. You could see number 93 was closing in. 17, and that brings the horn fans up. Quarterback draw just to gain a couple of yards, and then they'll punt it away. Kendall and Sam Acho again bringing the heat, and there's just nothing.
Now they're not having a chance to show that development.
Second and 14, McCoy stands middle and moves short of the first down, but complete to Shipley, his roommate and long time fullback, and Cody Johnson, the short yardage running back for the Horns, as they'll go power to pick it up, and the big fella does. Right around the 30-yard line. So the Horns on the move here now with another first down. Quick strike. Great grab. First and 10. And going up for it was Malcolm, the lead fullback. And they're going to give it to the quarterback behind him. And McCoy trying to get to the end zone. Touchdown.
The first touchdown of the
actually at the half.
Hunter Lawrence. But it has been one-sided excellence.
Yes.
This is third and 7. And they still have only 2 first downs, so they'll have to punt it away. Texas D licking its chops. Deflected again, and this one is intercepted. Picked off at the 35 by middle linebacker Roderick McElroy. There's a young man who had 17 tackles again.
Eventually gets into this game.
McCoy is stripped down by Matt O'Hanlon.
Play clock's down to 2.
Got it off. It's going to be a play action from his own end zone. Throws high. Almost intercepted. Gideon took a shot at it on the far side. He already has 1. Haven't had much to cheer about on either side offensively. And McCoy takes off and slides safely with the first down.
Here running the football.
McCoy straight back. Waits. Now comes back near side. And that one not of bounds. Williams again the intended. Yarder is good. A 4-point lead.
Happy State.
High kick is fielded by Paul at the 5-yard line. Paul explodes looking for the big play. There is their best burst with the football all night. Complete. Their biggest pass play of the night. And Brandon Kansas coaching job. That what a great choice that would be. As down the near sideline, up in the air, incomplete. Second man in. Great teamwork in that secondary. Thomas. Green, nothing doing. Keenan Robinson, number 1. McCoy's going down again. That time, Crick, along with Turner, did the job, and McCoy. Tucker booms one. Ball's got it. Good field position coming up. 25, Hunter to beat. Stretches free, still going. And it'll be first and goal for Nebraska. Back lead, and Nebraska to take the lead. He's back. Throws fade, far Turner. Paul's got it, out of bounds. No. Side judge was right there. And Brandon Kinney, a 28-yarder. He does. We got a one-point game. 11.5 minutes to go. Three has from Nebraska. Colts going to throw it out from the end zone. Diving catch at the 15-yard line. He goes to his buddy Shipley.
To that defensive line because of how quick they're getting the pass rush.
McCoy back on second down. Fires complete. Out to the 36-yard line, Malcolm Williams. And he is in the slot, his comfort zone on this 3rd and 16. But McCoy is going to go sideline. Williams reaches up and grabs it near midfield. Well, first down on 3rd and 16. Quarterback draw. 8 yards, tough yards from an eye on McCoy with this formation. Third down. Fires in underneath, and he's got the first down. Goodwin, the freshman, makes the catch across the 40-yard line, and the chain. Third down again for McCoy and the Longhorns. Fires short of the first down and taken away by Gomes. Gomes has got it, intercepted. What a play by Gomes. It looked like Buckner had the catch, and Gomes took it away.
Unbelievable. F. Gomes rips the ball away from him in a tenacious effort and attitude to get that football back to Nebraska.
The junior from Hayward, California. We'll see if they can do anything. Handing off, keeping down the middle. Fine play by Zach Lee. Had everybody fooled on the handoff to Burkhead. Kept it in. Zach got one-on-one, got the first down. And then some to the 30-yard line. Brandon Kinney, the 6'3 sophomore. It's exactly what they're doing, Herbie. Just exactly what you said they would do. Get it to the 25. Now, Alex Henry has kicked to upset a heavily favored Texas Longhorn team.
And Colt McCoy needs to get his dobber up here, because even if they make this field goal, Colt McCoy is going to have plenty of time with the timeout to get down into field goal range himself.
43-yarder. On its way, he's got it. Nebraska takes the lead. We are a minute 44 away from BC.
With the game, the ball in your hands and the game on the line.
The middle to Shipley, and Shipley runs free. And there's a penalty flag. Oh, he settles in at 5. Quarterback draw, and he bounces back out to the left side, and Gomes wrestles him down for a yard loss.
Here before the field goal attempt. Better hurry up.
Third down and 13. Roll pocket right. Throw it out of bounds and stop the clock. Wait a minute. Did the game end? Nebraska thinks it's over. McCoy may have run the clock out. Mack thinks there's a second left. I thought there was a second left. I think Bo Pelini should settle down the Nebraska.
After further review, there's 1 second left on the game clock. Fourth down.
Actually gets rid of the ball, but nonetheless, they still have the 1 second.
The 46-yarder. For everything. Got it. Texas goes to Pasadena. Jesse Palmer, take it away from Cowboy Stadium, where another classic has unfolded.